Luke Schneider, one of the Yankers, and Rourke Shirdy's the other one. This week, we're going to be taking you on location to every single story. So, sit back, get a cold drink, and enjoy. Do you got blood?
I don't got blood.
Okay. Are you 17?
I'm not 17, I'm older than 17.
Okay. Do you weigh at least 110 pounds?
No, I weigh more than 110 pounds.
Really? Well, then I don't think you'd be a good candidate for giving blood then, would you?
No, I don't weigh 110 pounds.
Well, Cherie, I believe you had a story to explain everything and what you even got getting the blood.
I was thinking about giving blood, but I don't know anything about it.
February 9th, the FFA and the FCCLA will be sponsoring a Red Cross blood drive that will be in the back gyms. You have to be 17 years of age. You have to weigh 110 pounds. You can't have a self-inflicted piercing within the past year, or you can't have a tattoo within the past year.
So if you fit all the requirements, come down to the nurse's office and grab one of these yellow sheets. Make sure your parents sign it, though, even if you are 18.
It only takes about an hour. There isn't a lot of pain involved. There's a pricking to see whether or not you're anemic or you're able to continue on giving blood. And then the actual donating takes about 10 minutes. They'll take a pint of blood, and then when you get done, they'll bring you over to a canteen where you'll be served. Could be pizza, could be fresh food, cheeses, crackers, and have a chance to sit before we send you back to class.
That sounds good to me. What kind of pizza are they going to have?
Hope to see all y'all down there. This has been Shree Rice from Chi Hi Happs.
Luke, why are you behind the couch?
I don't know. I just don't feel that, work is worth working for anymore in school.
Well, it has to do with senioritis. You have senioritis, Luke?
Maybe. What is senioritis, anyway?
Andrea Marco maybe has the answer.
What's senioritis?
What's senioritis?
What's senioritis?
Senioritis is the condition that seniors suffer from, which causes them to believe that they do not need to work as hard, since second semester has kicked in. Let's go find out who thinks that they have it.
Yeah, I think I get a little case of the senioritis. Sometimes I just want to stay in bed. I mean, why should I even bother waking up? I already got enough credits to graduate.
Yeah, I have senioritis, but who doesn't have senioritis? Why wouldn't you want to get out of school? School's no fun.
The first semester of school went really well for me, I'm just kind of sick of it now, my second half of the semester is going to be pretty easy, but I'd still like to get out of here, try to get some fellow work release, senior, study room.
I definitely have senioritis. I don't want to go to school right now. Second semester of my senior year.
I've had senioritis for about 2 years now.
And now, who doesn't have this strange disease?
Me, senioritis? I don't think so.
Yeah, I'm not going to talk about my diseases.
I have Wisconsinitis.
What's senioritis? I love school.
If you are one of the many seniors suffering from senioritis, try to tough it out, because you may not think that your grades are mattering right now, but yet they really do. This has been Andrea Marco reporting for Chi Hi Happenings.
See, over there, we got the basketball team behind us, And they had a little shindig with the teachers last Monday.
On Monday night, Chi Hi's highly talented seniors took on the teachers. The game was hot.
I'm really impressed with this team, these troopers, these warriors I have here. We've been putting in some long hours for the last couple months or so. These teachers clearly are not prepared for this, and it'll show tonight.
Early on, it was all the students as Lindsay Rosenau got the students on the board first with an easy layup. Students were wheeling and dealing early as Brock Schweissel was hot from outside. The teachers fought back as Vic Cable knocked down the key three. Bartles was tough inside all night long.
Oh,
but he wasn't quite so hot from the free throw line. Clank!
The students couldn't keep the teachers off the board all month. The students wouldn't go away as Tyrell Simons knocked on a key three-pointer.
Tied with 6:18 to play, Mr. Blair and Mr. Cable took over as they dominated down the stretch.
As Brock Schweistar lost his hot hand, the teacher simply took over.
It's a hard-fought game. They came to play. The students came to play this year. A lot of good athletes out there. It's the toughest game we've had so far in the 3 years we've done this. We were lucky to come out on top. Late run, veterans, a little bit of savvy, and just enough to pull it out at the end. Hit some big shots, and we finally got a few rebounds. And our girls played fantastic. The female faculty, great job by them. I got the snapper, better loose, then I lock you. Feel the juice, then I got you. When you produce a rocker, I let you meet mama and introduce you to papa. My remains in a Gucci name. Never test my patience, sweetie, I'm high maintenance. High class, if you ain't rolling, bypass. If you ain't holding, I dash, yo. Can I get a wop, 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 wop from all of my dogs who don't love dough? They get no dough. Can I get a take these fellas from all of my ladies who don't got?
So, LaPointe.
Yes.
Were you around when the school had a rifle range in the basement?
Well, I'm old, but I'm not that old. But Nick Wozniak has the story.
Sure. Did you know that the high school had a rifle club that had meetings once a week down in the basement of the high school? They had a fire range down there where they shot 22 caliber rifles.
Here's Dr. Sutter.
Okay, many years ago, I'm not sure exactly how many years ago, the school had some space beneath the stage area down in by the auditorium, and this was made into a rifle range. And I think this was part of a cooperative effort that the school had with the rifle club in town here. The reason that it's no longer being used as a rifle range is really twofold. First of all, the space wasn't being used by the club any longer or by any other school organizations or groups. And second of all, we really had some difficulty justifying having a rifle range in a high school. And so we needed the space desperately for storage, and so we're using it for storage right now. I believe the graduating class party group and the band and prom and some other groups are all using that space down below that area right now. I discovered that the school owned some rifles and also had the blank casings from ammunition and so on. And we have donated that to the Chippewa Falls Rifle Club. And so we no longer are in the gun business here at Chi Hi.
This has been Nick Wozniak reporting for Chi Happenings.
I gotta change my schedule.
Why, huh?
I was in this class. A good class, but I don't know, I just can't learn.
Can't learn? Has the teacher got you down?
I don't know if it's the teacher or if it's just kids.
Is there a bully in there picking on you?
Yes.
I was afraid of this. Well, I'm sure Jolynn, she could tell us where we could go to get our classes changed. Jolynn?
With the new semester starting, you may want to make a few changes in your schedule. You will need to go to the guidance office and set up an appointment to see your counselor. Report to your counselor at the appropriate time and date. Your counselor will tell you your options for classes to switch into and put you into a class. Then you can report to your new class. You might want to hurry though, because the class you want may be filling up fast. This has been Jolynn Wagoner reporting for Chi Hi Happenings.
The hallway
where people walk
and start crap,
bump into each other,
make you angry,
then you fight,
and then there's got to be someone there to step in.
Hall monitors.
Right.
Yes.
And always guarantee that everyone is there or being safe.
That's why Chi Hi has turned to the use of hall monitors to keep things under control. Here's our assistant principal on a little more on what hall monitors are.
The purpose of really having hall duty supervisors or monitors, teacher, adult supervisor monitors in the hallways is to maintain a safe and orderly environment in the building. It's important that students are in their classrooms and they're not out and about in the hallways between classes. Oftentimes there may be an adult in the building perhaps coming in to visit and they need some help or direction, and it's nice to have some people out there to let them know where they should go. Basically though, it's a safety and an order procedure to just make sure that things are going the way they need to be going. And if someone happens to need help out there in a certain part of the building, these people are available to provide it. And I don't know of any school, especially a high school or a secondary school, that doesn't have some kind of staff members that are in the hallways at different times throughout the day to keep the environment safe and appropriate.
I don't have one. You have to have them.
Right.
You cannot stay controlled by yourself.
Hall supervision is a duty assigned by the administration for the purpose of controlling hall traffic and activity. We do this by checking students' passes. The duty is not difficult because of the support of staff making sure that students are always accounted for.
Even on the most calmest days of the week, it can still bring skippers, roamers, and trouble to the halls. That's why we have teachers surveilling. But there are always the few that always figure out how to skip.
If you see me, like, walking out with my coat, don't stop me anymore, okay? Because I'm leaving.
This has been Luke Schneider reporting for Chi Hi Happenings.
I hear there's going to be a carnival this weekend.
Yeah, I kind of got conned into going to it.
I didn't.
God, you're so lucky.
Kara has a story.
Are you bored? Sick of the endless winter days? Well, why not come to Chi Hi's first winter carnival on Saturday the 27th? What better way to start off second semester than with a dance? Admission is only $5 and it will be held from 8 to midnight in the cafeteria. Plus, there will be a live band performing and a DJ. That means almost nonstop music for 4 hours. Are you sure that's something you want to pass up?
Most people don't come to the non-formal dances, so we thought a formal dance would be good. There will be a live band. The band is Livid. And it will also be DJ'd too, so when the band takes breaks, we'll have a DJ. It should be a lot of fun, and we want everybody to come. It should be a blast. Don't worry about like buying expensive dresses or anything. Trade with your friends or something. That's what a lot of people are doing. And just come and have a good time.
Student Council chose this week for Winter Carnival because it's after finals and it wouldn't interfere with any testing.
I think that it'll be a lot better next year with Winter Carnival because people will know that it's coming. And I think it's better to have the big dance, and I think that it will be a lot of fun.
I think the thing that's going to be the funnest about Winter Carnival is that there will be a live band there, and our school's never had a dance with a live band before that I know of, so I think it'll be a really fun time, so everyone should come, and you don't have to buy a new dress or anything, just borrow one, and come and have a good time.
Hey, I'm going to Winter Carnival. It's going to be really cool. It's going to be a good time. It's going to be a live band. Winter Carnival rules!
So are you ready to have a good time? This has been Kara Bagley for Chi.
Where does Joe work?
I don't know.
Does Joe work?
Probably not.
Joe better work.
Better work better than
me. Joe better work.
There can be good things and bad things about having a job and going to school. Good thing is you got cash to pay for stuff. The bad thing is you might have to work late at night and you don't have time to get your homework done, and that could make you fall behind in school.
I think it really stinks that sometimes you have to work to make, because I mean, I need money to pay my car insurance, and right now I have 2 classes down at Tech, and I have to stay here, and then I have 2 Tech classes, and then I have to go to work at night, usually until 10 o'clock at night, and I work all the way down in Eau Claire. So I mean, it's a really big pain. By the time I get home, it's 11 o'clock, and I have like no time to do my homework or anything.
Some of the advantages of having a job is getting out, meeting people, and working with them. And disadvantages are not having spare time to do things you really want to.
I like my workplace because it gives me a lot of free time to do whatever I want. I don't work very much, but when I do work, I get a lot of money for it.
I like my job, but it takes up a lot of time from me
being able to do a lot of other things like hanging out with my friends or going to school-related activities.
I don't think students should work. I think they should go to school. I think school should be their job. Later on, when they're older and maybe they have more flexibility in their schedules, then I think getting a job is fine. But in the meantime, I have too many kids that have two jobs. Some kids even have three jobs, and they don't get their work done. I think until you graduate from high school, you know, school should be a job.
I hate working. Working stinks. It takes away from sleep time.
Yes, I love my job. You know, it gives me a lot of free time, a lot of flexibility. Sometimes I feel like I don't even work at all. I mean, it just gives me so much freedom. I love it.
Actually, my one goal and the thing that I want to do when I grow up is be a professional student. You know, it's probably not going to happen. I want to be paid to take college courses that I want to take.
Where are all the Russians?
Betty J.
Betty J.
Where'd the Russians go, man?
The jungle party.
This past Wednesday, the Russian Club took a trip. A trip to Chicago to visit the Field Museum of Natural History, where they visited the Kremlin Gold. Unfortunately, cameras were not allowed inside the exhibit, but there was lots of cool other stuff to see. Like these mummies, for example, which are probably really, really old. And this old boat. Mummies weren't the only thing they had at the museum. They also had Sue, the world's largest and most complete Tyrannosaurus Rex. But Sue wasn't the only dinosaur they had at the museum. There was also this Brontosaurus, which was really, really big and really, really cool. But that's not the only cool thing in this museum besides dinosaurs and mummies. Here's what some other people thought.
What's your guys' favorite exhibit so far?
I like the man-eating lions. They're really big looking. They look kind of mean too.
I think the Russian trip's pretty fun. I come down here, cool stuff all around me. It's a great time. I just hope the day never ends.
But by the end of the day, some people thought the museum was getting pretty old.
Anyway, the Russian trip is going pretty good. We only have about 3 more hours left. We've seen every single exhibit except this one. This is a fish exhibit. Pretty cool, huh?
I thought it was pretty fun. We didn't need that much time at this museum. It's not all that great. I think Mr. Lick expected us to read everything, read every little thing for it to take 5 hours because we went through it in 1 hour.
It's a big museum, but they really don't got that much stuff. Some of it was pretty cool, but a lot of it was stupid.
But overall, I think everybody had a really good time on the trip. Maybe some people even learned some stuff. This has been Matt Johnston reporting for Chi Hi Happenings.
Now for the exciting conclusion of Washing Your Car in the Dark.
Washing Your Car in the Dark. I'll show you what we have right here. We have a bucket of water and a car. Can't tell how dirty it is, but it is a car. A dirty car on the outside. And we are about to wash it. First, you must get the car wet. Next, wash. Oh, there's a difference. Oh yeah, there's a big difference right there. Going down the side. Here we'll wash right here. There we go. Yeah, that's nice. That's nice. Oh, what's that? Look at that. There we go. You will now see that there's ice forming. This may have something to do with the cold. Yes, it has something to do with it being cold out. Now we'll just have to wait until morning to see if it really does pay off. Okay. See you then. Wow, have you been here all night? Well, let's take a look. Look at the hood. It's all frosted over with like ice. Sweet. Oh, that side's clean. Oh, I guess I did miss a little, didn't I? Yeah, there's a spot right there.
In conclusion, I would not wash my car in the dark again unless I was paid. This has been Rorik Shooty reporting for Chi Hi Happenings.
The end of our show. Thank you for watching. Make sure to tune in next week because we're going to be on. The nights are all long.